Hello and welcome to the Fishing Creek Craft Show Virtual Edition. My name is Whitney with WMG Productions, and I'm so excited that you're here with us today. The Fishing Creek Craft Show is typically an in-person artisan craft series held quarterly at Catawba Falls Events. We launched our first show back in December, and it was a huge success. We had our spring show planned for March, but we did have to cancel that because of the coronavirus. While we were a little disappointed, we are so excited because creative minds have came together to put together this virtual edition of the show for you instead. Today, we have some amazing artists and vendors with us. We also have our friends from Catawba Falls to help us co-host, and they're going to give us all an exclusive tour of the venue. But for now, we're going to hop on over to our musical guest for the evening, Matt Tucker.
She's been going out with him, she's been going out with me, since she let us know by the night which one it would be. So I waited by the phone, but she never called me up, had to know what was going on, so I drove by. Sure enough, that ain't my truck in her drive. Man, this ain't my day tonight. Looks like she's in love and I'm out of love. That ain't my shadow on her wall. Lord, this don't look good at all. That's my girl, my whole world. Sitting here all night, wondering what it was I did so wrong, that he did so right. I thought of breaking down the door. There's nothing left to say. That Chevy 4x4 says it all. Sitting in my place, that ain't my truck. Looks like she's in love and I'm out of love. That ain't my shadow on the wall. Lord, this don't look good at all. That's my girl, my whole world, but that ain't my
Thank you so much for tuning in to this special production. We want to take a second to show you how this all works and how you can follow along at home. Log on to creeksidemerchant.com where you can view all the products, or you can view each vendor's inventory separately by utilizing the category section. Keep in mind, a portion of all sales on creeksidemerchant.com will be donated to Second Harvest Food Bank of Metro Lineup. There is also a section on our site where you can make a monetary donation that will go straight to their organization as well. Did you know that for every $1 raised, Second Harvest Food Bank of Metro Lineup is able to provide over 7 pounds of food for our friends and neighbors in need? That's amazing. So just rest assured knowing that your money and donation are going to a great cause, because Second Harvest Food Bank actually supplies most of the food banks here in our area, which most people do not know. Now, I'm very excited to introduce a good friend of mine who is super talented at her craft. Let's head over to Purple Girl Designs by Amber and hear a little bit about her journey.
Hey, I'm Amber with Purple Girl Designs. I started Purple Girl Designs back about 6 years ago after I found out that I was getting laid off from my corporate job. I had worked in television for about 15 years and they had given us a notice of 6 months that we were going to be leaving, and I thought, well, okay, that's interesting. What do I do now? I actually had a friend take me to a psychic fair and I started being interested in spirituality and mindfulness. And after the 6 months was over and I got laid off from my job, I took my severance package and I went to the UK for about a year. I traveled and I lived and worked over there. And when I came back, I realized that my life's purpose was to help others. And that's how Purple Girl became. And I am very grateful for all of it. Purple Girl Designs actually is named after amethyst, and amethyst represents your heart chakra for love, joy, and compassion, as well as many other wonderful things. But compassion is the number one thing, and that's what Purple Girl is about.
Thank you, Amber. Compassion is also really important to us too. That is why it is really important for me to do more with the Fish and Creek Craft Show than just have a craft show. It's about helping local entrepreneurs succeed and for them to be able to provide for their families. And it's about raising awareness of artisan trades and keeping them alive. And of course, it's also about giving back to the community by raising money for Second Harvest Food Bank of Metro Lineup. Here in a few minutes, we're going to meet up with our friends over at Catawba Falls for an exclusive tour of the beautiful venue. But first, I want to introduce our friends over at the Craftsman Beverage Company. Hey guys!
Hey everybody, how are you doing? This is Steven with the Craftsman Beverage Company. Proud to be here. Glad everybody is out there watching. I hope everybody's safe. It's a pretty rough time for us right now, but stay safe and I'm sure we'll get through this. I just want to tell you a little bit about our company. It's a company run by myself, my wife, Katie, and our little daughter, Cooper, who is just over two. She's our little spokesperson, or potion child is a better way to do it. But anyway, I started the company. I've been a bartender and chef for about 15 years or so, and I started the company based upon folks asking me at the bar when I'm, you know, bartending, how can I make this cocktail at home? I said, you know, I make the syrup here in the restaurant, and he said, well, can you sell me the syrup? So that got my wheels turning a little bit, and I decided, all right, I need to bottle this stuff and see if we can make something out of just what I've been doing as bartending, which I love. It's great. So it turned into this craft cocktail company, or craft beverage company, really. These are both great for cocktails and tea. I personally like mixing mine with tea or even soda water. If you have a soda stream, it's really awesome to do it that way as well. So one thing led to another. The syrups took off. It was kind of a hit, to say the least. We started off in Rock Hill. Actually, we started off in Charlotte at a tomato festival. But we've been doing local markets, and now we've been selling online quite a bit. And then it moved into a little bit more. I started doing Bloody Mary mix. I named that Wake and Shit. Taking off the, you know, the popular phrase, what we all know, because Bloody Marys are always great in the mornings or as a brunch drink. So the Bloody Mary mix is actually one of my favorites. It's like my little, it's like my baby. Basically, it's all kinds of vegetables all mixed in together, and you can actually taste it rather than just tasting, not really bashing them, V8. It doesn't taste like a tomato soup or a tomato drink. You can actually taste each and every ingredient that's in there, such as fennel, garlic, mushrooms, all kinds of peppers and then tomatoes, of course. I make my own Worcestershire sauce, which is, I'm really proud to do because it's not the easiest thing, or it is, but it's just, I love making everything from absolute scratch. And that's another point that I wanted to make with this company is that everything is made from scratch. I take whole spices, raw sugar, nothing is processed. There's no preservatives. I only use citric acid in the syrup to extend the shelf life a little bit and to add some of that citrusy notes as well. So yeah, so I'm gonna go into it just a little bit right now of what my most popular product is. And that's gonna be our ginger syrup. The ginger syrup is made from raw ginger root, about 10 pounds of it in one batch. And it's about 10 pounds per 10 quarts. So it's got a nice heavy punch to it. It's sweetened with turbinado sugar. And it's unlike any ginger beer or ginger flavor that I've ever tasted. I also add baking spices to it and citrus juice as well as some herbs as well. So it just adds so much more depth to, say, a Moscow Mule, which is what I'm about to make right now. So, and I'm gonna do my version of the Moscow Mule. So basically what we're gonna do is start off with vodka. I add a little bit of triple sec or orange liqueur, Cointreau, Grand Marnier, Salerno, any kind of orange liqueur that you'd like to use. Triple sec is just the most basic. So we're gonna take our mule mug. Usually you want to use crushed ice. I don't have a crushed ice. Oh, we're out of my house right now, so I don't have a crushed ice machine at the house. So we're just going with good old at-home freezer ice. I'm going to do about 1.5 ounces, which is the standard pour for any or most cocktails. So 1.5 ounces, and then I've got some fresh lime juice that I squeeze. Do about 1/2 ounce of that. Orange liqueur, or you can make your own actually. I like to make mine a good bit. You can take orange peel, vodka, or any kind of base spirit that's 80 proof or above, macerate that, or let it sit for about a day or so, and then you just sweeten it with whatever sugar you like. Now, the most favorite part is the ginger syrup. And also, you want to give it a good shake because I didn't show you before, it does settle because it is made from actually raw ingredients. So we're gonna do 1/2 ounce of that. You really want to have that punch and a great ginger flavor that goes with it. And since the ginger syrup is not carbonated, all you can do is add some soda water. And this really is more along to your taste, however much you want. You can dilute as much as you need. You can either tumble it or give it a nice little stir. Copper mugs usually, ice will stick to the mug very easily, so sometimes it's easily easier to tumble it. And then you just want to garnish it with a slice of lime. And that's it. So thank you so much for looking at this, and we'll see you out there soon. Appreciate it.
Hello everyone, my name is Matt Starnes. I'm your wedding and events director here at Catawba Falls Events, and we are so excited to have the Fish and Creek Craft Show virtual edition here. We host them every single quarter, and we hope that you'll join us on our next event that we will have coming up. I'm going to turn you around. I would love to show you our venue and what we currently have here. And while I am just chitter-chatting away, I will explain a little bit about what you are seeing. So Catawba Falls Events is a full-service event venue where we oversee and manage all wedding, corporate, and private events here. Max capacity is 270 or 330 fluid throughout the property, which is inside and outside on our veranda and patio area. What you're seeing right here, and we will go into, is our bridal suite, our beautiful bar that was custom built by our owner, David Walden. These doors right here are on a farm hinge, which means they open and close throughout the event. These doors are over 300 years old, truly amazing. They come out of an old cathedral out of Florida, and we had them shipped up here just for all of our clients to enjoy and see. Now, Whitney, I want to show you this. This is really beautiful. Our beautiful mirror, which is right here, will lead you straight into our bridal suite. Absolutely gorgeous for all of our bride and bridesmaids. Anybody that needs to do hair and makeup to just enjoy themselves. Big mirror right there, so you can see yourself all dolled up and ready to go before you say I do. Gonna lead you straight back into here as well. Now, our private entrance will lead you straight into what we are known for. It's my favorite part of this venue. So welcome to our veranda area. So our veranda area is perfect for that summer cocktail. Enjoy a crisp glass of beer if you'd like that as well, or just a beautiful Carolina sunset. We back right up to Fishing Creek area, which is obviously why we are here today with Fishing Creek Craft Show. What you are seeing in this area right over here is our Catawba Falls area. And then also right here as well, where we have all of our arbor. All of our weddings take place right here as well. Or our brand new area, which we just finished, is our terrace area. And let me take you down there as well. This is our terrace area. It leads straight down into the Fishing Creek area, into the Catawba River. Absolutely gorgeous for a beautiful wedding, micro wedding, or an elopement, if you'd like that as well. Absolutely amazing. We just finished this. This has not even been unveiled to the public just yet, so you are getting a sneak peek, a secret view of it. Accommodations for this area can be up to 150 people, or just some of your close friends for a private dinner down there as well.
Been waiting all week for a night like this. Moonshine, stars falling, let's make a wish and pour a little bit of ice on it. Dive in, make a splash, let's take a dip. I'm thirsty for your love and I'm ready for a sip from your lips. Let's get drunk on this. Baby, let's screw top all that bottle, yeah. Tip it on back and I miss a swallow. Let's love in this moment, not think about tomorrow. Let's just screw the top all that bottle. On a blanket laying down, yeah, we're rocking out to some country sounds. I can feel the heat from the nighttime sun. Got a whole lot of kissing left to get done. Yeah, the night's still young for a little one-on-one. Baby, let's screw the top off that bottle and tip it on, babe. Baby, let's screw the top off that bottle. You tip it on big and I miss a swallow. Let's love in this moment, not think about tomorrow. Let's just screw the top off that bottle. Come on, baby, let's screw the top of that bottle.